Generative AI makes it faster than ever before to create chatbots. It used to take a lot of manual effort to craft conversational responses and flows, but now LLMs promise to cut some of the time and effort out of the build process by doing more of the work for us. If we say goodbye to handcrafted answers, is that a good trade-off? Today we'll discuss how to balance human and LLM control while building effective chatbots. Let's look at how we used to build chatbots before generative AI. We used to train chatbots to understand natural language through classifiers. So we might have something like, what time are you open? And we would craft an hour's intent for this. Classifiers are trained on examples, so we'd give multiple examples for this intent. So maybe I would do, when do you close? And again, same intent. And for this intent, I'd want to very carefully control the answer. And I would say something like, we're open 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. every day. I want people to really know what the answer is to that hour's question. I would also train additional intent. So maybe I would have one like, how do I open an account? This would go to an account intent. And again, I would very carefully control what happens from that. Maybe I would open the account for them. Maybe I would give them some steps to follow. But again, the point is I had a very strict control over what happened when I got this intent, no matter how it was asked. Let's imagine how this training kind of scaled out. So I could plot a curve for the kinds of questions my chatbot received. I would use the number of times I get each question on one axis. I would do the frequency of the questions on the other. And when I do that, it tends to look something like this. So I've got a nice long curve here. And at the top of the curve is the questions I get all the time. So I probably get that hours kind of question the most. And then accounts, I probably get that a lot, maybe not quite as much. So let's say it's here, right? It's still a very frequently asked question. It's just that it's not the most frequently asked. And then I'm going to have a nice long curve of questions here. And there'll be questions that I hardly ever get, like, how do I use my gold card while traveling overseas? Right? Maybe I only get this question one time. And as I progress through this curve, it gets harder and harder to train the classifier to understand these things. And there's actually a point somewhere along the curve, we'll call it here, where you've gone past the point of diminishing returns. It gets so hard to train intents that your chatbot starts not understanding. And you end up seeing a lot of responses like, hey, I didn't understand that, or it starts answering the wrong question and just starts looking confused. And this is a really poor experience for your users. And so this is where generative AI comes in. Using retrieval augmented generation, we don't need to train any classifiers. As long as the answer to our user's question is in the document repository used by the system, the RAG system can answer any question. The training is very generalized. So the process would look something like this. We've got a user here. They're asking questions to the chatbot. The chatbot is sending that question to a document repository. That repository retrieves some documents that help. And the bot sends those documents and the question to the LLM. The LLM summarizes the answer. Right? So it's a very generalized process. Again, we have a user question converted into a search query. The query returns some documents, and then those retrieved or returned documents are augmented by the LLM in a generated answer. And so with this pattern, the LLM can answer both the very frequent and the infrequent questions. And there's a real beautiful simplicity in this pattern. There's only two configuration points. So number one, you have the tuning of the search, the query, the retrieval process. And number two, you have the tuning of the answer generation process. Two points, very simple, very generalized, no intents. But you lose some degree of control. Remember that when people asked me when my store is open, I had a really particular answer in mind I wanted to give. I wanted to make sure they got exactly this text. And in this pattern, I don't have that exact control anymore. The LLM can't give me that guarantee. So what's the answer? It's a hybrid approach. So we're going to use a traditional classifier part of the time, and we're going to use RAG the other half of the time. So if I draw this out, it starts out the same. My user's asking a question to the bot, but the bot's making a decision. Is this a question I see all the time? In which case, I'm going to go with my intents slash the curated responses. And if this is something I don't get that much, I'm going to go with the RAG pattern that I've shown up here. And if we look at our original long tail curve, we can think of this left-hand side as a kind of a cache. Right? Those questions we get all the time, it can pull right out of its internal memory. We're not going to the LLM. We're not doing any of these searches. We're not worrying about tokens and inference time and all those things. So using this side as the cache is very quick. So find a balance between fully generated conversational responses and generative AI-powered RAG. This will help you build effective conversational AI that delights your users as quickly as possible.